Welcome. This is part two of the Deep Fractal Plasma Science of the 2012 story from Dan Winter, goldenmean.info/carringtonevent. In this part, we discuss the plasma science of the nine, starting with the Whale Dreamers story. As you know, the Whale Dreamers film, funded by John Lennon's son, goldenmean.info/whaledreamers is the excerpt. We see that in the film, they're talking about this wave envelope, this plasma storm that hits, in this case, off of South Australia, and at the Bight, south of Adelaide, and where the whale dream is projected into the stars. And we're looking at the science from Los Alamos, the article from John McGovern, and the plasma science group at Los Alamos Institute. They mapped this plasma storm that hit the South Australian every 6,000 years. It's comparable to Shiva or Vishnu in an envelope, as we see here. The important dynamic to discover there was that the plasma storm actually was arranged, composed of seven of these nested donuts. I'm sorry, nine. There were nine donuts in that array, and it was discovered that, in fact, plasma storms in general self-organize into that array of the nine, as it were, accounting for why the Hopi called it, remember, the way of the nine, Peshmate in deep space, nine and all that, and why you have nine chakras, two above your seven, because it takes nine donuts in a plasma storm in a line to create that self-organizing life field, which is why there are nine steps of Palenque, the pagoda, and also the Ennead and the Anunnaki Egyptian nine concept. So when the plasma scientists discovered the geometry of that, if you see here, that the cross-section of that donut, one of the donuts in that plasma storm, had actually been carved by the shaman all around the earth because he had seen it and felt it in their body, as if to say shamanically navigated that plasma storm. And that they saw the actual latitude where the shaman had carved the picture of the plasma storm indicated their attitude with reference to it, indicated that, in fact, they knew that as they navigated their plasma body shamanically, shem-on, as it were, they were actually seeing this giant body of God, as it were, and that's what the Plasma Universe websites are about, that the plasma shapes of the stars are, in fact, the shape of what was called God. And so we see that the nine interdigitated golden ratio tetrahedron, which correspond to what's been called the Sri Yantra, in fact correspond to nine interdigitated opposing vortex cones, literally phase conjugating. We have many images of that. And then there's that lovely film about that from, it's called The Last Mimsy. Let me get to the right slide here. And in The Last Mimsy, the kids are seen navigating into the stars in the shape of that Sri Yantra, if I can get this gadget, get a right animation here, 1 second. So the concept was that the double opposing vortex cones, which are how you insert your plasma into stars, there it is again from Last Mimsy. Sorry, we had a little burp here. So this is the film Last Mimsy, and it's about the Sri Yantra and how children use that to actually affect the power grid, and they do it from this perspective of the nine. So the last part of this presentation will be about understanding the physics of alphabets and how the plasma storm making a center helps us understand the science of alphabets. And sorry, our visuals aren't keeping up with us very well here. But the remember we had in the Hebrew alphabet, we had the spiral on a donut, angle into compression, indexed by the spin of the tetrahedron. So if you form a Hebrew letter in your brain and focus on it, it causes the plasma donut, which is your optical cortex, to be tilted to that phase angle, and then you blow that donut and you send that smoke ring at that phase angle, that vortex. And if you nest them properly, you get a golem. So and that's sort of the Hebrew alphabet story here. You remember that story. Here's some of the animations about that. Remember, there's the hey as in yod, hey, vah, hey. But then we're going to just look briefly at the superset alphabet, the Ophanimanokian, because it's so explicitly hypercube dodeca, teaching us to do that phase shift, that implosion. So John Dee and Kelly saw these Ophanim letters in the plasma shape inside the green stone, and we recommend goldenmean.info/Ophanim, O-P-H-A-N-I-M, for this story. The point I want to make, though, is that after Vincent Bridges noted that those letters were arrayed in a hypercube, and that hypercube was this shape, you see the 6 around 1, 7 cubes would then compress on the outside in the tetracubic. What on the inside would be 5 cubes, which is the dodecahedron, which in our view is the only hypercube. And that creates this completed compression algorithm that you could blow the donuts, the vortex phase angles, to assemble them into the dodeca, the hyper.